Hello and welcome to the Prinsco Pro4 Overview. I'm Judd Effinger, Regional Manager for Prinsco. In this video, we'll be covering some install information on using Pro4 chambers in a gravity trench.
Nearly 30% of all U.S. households are served with an on-site septic system, and that number is likely to increase as people move into rural areas that aren't connected to public sewers. On-site septic systems consist of a septic tank and a drain field. The tank collects and provides primary treatment of the wastewater by separating solid waste from liquid, with bacteria breaking down the organic matter. The partially treated effluent then flows into the drain field, where it is dispersed for absorption and final treatment in the soil. The septic tank should be inspected and pumped out a minimum of every 5 years to ensure that solids do not enter the Prinsco Pro4 chambers. Originally, a drain field would have been built with pipe and gravel, but gravel comes with a host of problems.
It's heavy and difficult to transport and install. It's hard to find and expensive in many areas, and it can be embedded with fine dust material. The development of more efficient gravelless pipe and eventually plastic leaching chambers led to a 20 to 50% reduction in drain field size. Prinsco Pro4 chambers are a highly efficient gravelless drain field solution for residential and commercial septic systems. They were specifically designed for the professional contractors who are looking for cost efficiency, delivery convenience, ease of installation, and maximized drain field infiltration. I'd like to show you some of the new features of the chambers. The first is the asymmetrical arch. This is designed with opposing arches that push against each other and make for what we think is the strongest chamber on the market. It also allows for our sidewall to have an elevated sidewall, a full 8.5 inches. The third feature is the bowl-on-bowl articulating joint, and we'll show you more about that feature a little later. The fourth feature is our end cap. It allows for multiple enter points and is also used to cap off the end of the trench. Let's talk about the other products you're going to need in addition to the chambers and end caps. You'll need PVC pipe, PVC couplings, threaded clean-out cap or non-threaded cap for inspection ports, a drill, a hole saw, a rake, and a shovel. And now we're ready for the installation. The first two steps are always to call your local health department to make sure you have the location approved. The second is to call 811 to make sure that all the lines have been marked prior to your dig. Once your location is found, your next step is to dig a level trench for the chamber install. Every trench starts with our end cap, which connects to the pipe from the septic tank. Today we're using the standard inlet, and we'd also like to point out the splash guard, which is detachable. The detachable splash guard can easily be removed and then is rotated and placed inside the end cap like such. Now that we have the splash guard installed, let's look at inletting the 4-inch. Today we've pre-drilled with a hole saw a 4-inch hole that will connect to the 4-inch pipe. You'll want to have it about 2 inches into the end cap. And now we'll install the end cap on top of the first chamber. Note that you want to make sure you have the inlet end of the chamber. It's simply an overlapping joint. You'll hear a click and then make sure you see the connection on each side. And now we'll continue down the trench installing chambers. You'll notice how lightweight and easy it is to carry a chamber by yourself. The first step is to overline the two bowls and wait for a click for full engagement. And now the fourth benefit that we talked about earlier, which is the articulating joint. If you happen to be on a trench that has a contour, our chambers simply rotate on top of that bowl 10 degrees in either direction. So we'll keep installing the chambers until we get to the end of the trench. And then we'll take the end cap, align the two bowls, and wait for the click for full engagement. And now we'll move on to the backfill process. The first step is to pull your best material off the side of the trench into the wedge along the sidewall louver. This is 8.5 inches. And then we'll walk in the sidewall with human compaction, and this will allow for a nice stable base prior to backfill. The final step is to install the optional inspection port. We've pre-drilled 4 1/4 inch cutouts for both the chamber and the end cap. And now we're ready to install the inspection port. There are a variety of methods listed in our instruction manual. We're using the preferred method, which is the two coupler extension. The first is to have an internal coupler with a pipe stub, which sticks out from the bottom of the chamber. This allows for the inspection pipe and the external coupler to glue onto that internal coupler. And now we've got the full extension, which is capped with a 4-inch cap. Now you're ready for the final backfill. For the final backfill, you'll want a ladle, at least 12 inches of cover on top of the chamber. Allow for an extra 3 or 4 inches of mounding for the compaction of the soil. The next important step is to make sure that you're driving over the chamber during the compaction phase, perpendicular to the chamber lateral. Do not drive over parallel to the chamber lateral. An industry standard now is to backfill with a tracked backhoe. This allows for 6 inches of non-traffic loading weight bearing, or the full 12 inches for the wheel loading of H10 loading. This is 16,000 pounds per axle. The final step is to mound over the system with topsoil, seed, or sod for final installation. A gravity trench will very likely be the appropriate application for most septic needs. You may feel you need another application, such as a bed, mound, or those with a pressure distribution. In that case, we recommend consulting with your wastewater expert on your particular situation. It's been a pleasure to walk through the installation of the Prinsco Pro4 chambers. Don't forget to get more detailed information in the install documentation. And if you need more help, we're just a phone call or an email away.